Melanchikun's actually got a better win rate against left-handed players like Benedict Duda than he has overall in his career. 85% of lefties he's beaten.
Remember in one of his big breakthrough tournaments, Liang Jingquin, the Austrian Open, where he beat Fan Zhendongan Shuxin, the cloud walker, in the final.
1-0.
He's such a strong player, Liang.
2-1.
Big guy himself, slightly stockier, but he's got a slinging forehand. An underrated touch play, I'd argue.
1-3.
He has, though, Liang Jingquin, been very vulnerable to Europeans. He's lost to Jorgic, he's lost to Shalbury. Of course, he's lost to Alexia Lebrun as well in Macau.
1-4.
We look at Duda's record against Chinese players. 8%.
How many has he played?
25. Won twice.
Okay.
He starts pretty well.
It's funny how players blossom at different ages. Some earlier than others. I mean, you could actually say that success at a young age is a very dangerous thing. Maybe this is the right time for Duda to get another win.
5-2.
With all that's happening in the world of table tennis, with how much the Chinese are getting tested in recent times, it's possible. 2-6. Look at this ripping counter off the bounce from the dude. 6-2 up. Half long push gets the bat high. That was robotic.
3-6.
Yeah, pretty decent here from Duda.
6-4.
Maybe you were saying about Lin Shedong and how you felt he might be the one edging things against Liang Jingquin. What are Liang Jingquin's strengths for you?
It's extremely powerful.
6-4.
Very solid counter, a good from mid-distance. Quite quick as well, in and out. Nice touch play, he's got a nice reverse pendulum and pendulum serve. But Duda has got that as well with the reverse, and you can see it wins him that point. Liang has minerals too. Seen him win some tough matches like Pitchford in Houston, 4-3, and then Calderano from 3-0 down. To my knowledge, he's never actually lost to a non-Chinese player at a World Championships, Liang Jingquin.
That's impressive.
6,
and he's only a point behind
7.
Now. Liang Jingquin right on the tail of Benedict Duda, who had a very good start.
7-4. Picked his pocket there.
Well, he was enjoying a fairly decent lead, Benedict Duda. And he now goes in front, Liang Jingquin. Good run of points for him. There you go, 6 of the last 8 have gone for Liang there.
5-6. Shuffling in and out there, Duda. As a left-handed player, he brings his left leg in underneath the table for the touch play. the reciprocal if you're a righty. For a big guy, he moves very, very quickly. Mm. Usually you see Torpe is a little bit more lumbersome than what he is.
9-8.
Very active. This could be a feisty match, this, Shahzad.
Yeah, so far we haven't necessarily seen too many indications.
Off
the edge there, an apology from Liang Jingkun. And he's got two game points. So he does convert now, Liang Jingkun, that they seem to have.
Well, they're less common, and the fact of the matter is Liang's forehand is a bit stronger than his backhand. And the longest length to play is cross table, so Duda has an advantage in that sense because his forehand is obviously coming. Cross into that, but look at this from Liang Jingkun.
Great on the backhand.
Commentator's curse. Now that is a serious cause for concern. Oh, look how he's toughing these out.
What?
Yeah, he's got his coach on his feet. What a point. You can only just watch it passing by. Benedict Duda.
Interesting. Oh, he's coming out a different player here, isn't he, Liang Jingkun?
How much do you think Liang Jingkun would be sort of taking notice of Lin Shedong's defeat of Fan Zhendong as we see the points there in favour of Liang Jingkun by quite some distance? 12 of the last 16 have gone his way.
I doubt I'll be thinking about it too much, in fairness, Shahzad. Mm-hmm. Can't afford to. They roll as a unit, the Chinese, but this is...
Four, three.
All of a sudden, his backhands aren't calibrating as well, Liang, but maybe that's because Duda's playing with slower spin. Liang wants it fast.
That's the way he might want to go about this, right, Duda?
Mm. Perhaps, perhaps.
Oh. 4-5.
Well, no matter what you throw at these players, these Chinese players, they always have a way.
He's just been absolutely burgled. What a shot from Liang Jingkun. Mesmerising.
Really was. Effortless, wasn't it?
6-4.
The more effort you put into your shots sometimes, the worse. You've got to have a relaxed grip. Any tension in the forearms, bad, you've got to be relaxed to hit those fine margins. You can't recover, you can't move quick if you're tense. Like a bodybuilder, less flexible than a martial arts fighter, for example. It's not encouraged to do too much training on the upper body as a table tennis player.
Yeah, I think it's showing.
5-7.
Just relieving that pressure.
Thank you.
has lost to a German this season, Liang Jingquin. Lost to Dang Cho at the finals men. So this year rather, not this season. The German also beat Lin Shidong in the round before.
Yeah, we look at the record of these two this year, and Benedict Dunas played 7 matches prior to coming here. He's won 4 of those. As for Liang Jingquin, he's also not played that many. He's had 7 matches this year, 4 wins, 3 losses.
9-6.
He's still looking to narrow that lead. Liang Jingquin is 2 away from making it 2-0. Benedict Duda may have some other ideas. He's got to try something different. Well, on serve.
Let's see if he does a reverse pendulum again. He's not gonna. Pendulum serve on the touch lets him down.
7-10.
Might not have even been a shocking touch.
3 game points in for Liang Jingquin.
The way he swept in over that one. With that full stroke forehand, Liang.
11-7.
This backhand's been way too good, hasn't it?
Yeah, it really has. Liang superb Jingquin again.
Wang Chuqin has Ma Long in his pocket when it comes to WTT finals.
Yeah, all that will happen on Sunday, the men's and women's singles final.
One, all.
Yeah, we've got another Germany-China clash this evening in the aforementioned Ma Long taking on Benedict Duda's compatriot, Patrick Francisca.
Francisca has beaten Ma Long as well in the past, which makes that one interesting too. Beat him a couple of years ago at the European Summer Series. Fantastic result for Big France.
3-1.
Yeah.
Timeout.
Timeout there being called by the German. You're down by 2. 3-1 down as well in the third. You are playing one of the best players in the world.
One.
Well, there is something special about Liang Jingquin. The way he approaches it. So actually, one of the most emotional players on the Chinese team in him. More animated players. We've seen him actually receive a ban before.
Yep, I know where you're going with this.
2-5.
Yeah, he's, I suppose in that sense, a little bit more outspoken than some of the others. A bit individual in that sense.
0 tolerance policy, of course, for China. In terms of any conceivable misdemeanor. But, of course, very respectful player at the same time. No questions about that.
Yeah, there have been a few Chinese players over the years who've maybe just been a bit more expressive than some of the others. He's comfortable here, 5 up. Liang Jingquin, that lead that he's got.
2-8.
Yeah,
3-8. Eight, four. Nine, four.
It's almost done, isn't it, this one?
Yeah. See no way here that Duda can claw this back. Hats off to Liang Jingquan of China.
Five, oh, right behind that nine. One, Duda with the Chiquita.
One of the best receives he's managed to manifest there.
Yeah.
Six.
Couple of points.
Nine. Timeout.
I think it's going with the match. That's my guess.
Nine.
Finish it off.
Seven.
You reckon?
Yeah, that's my. That's my.
That's your take.
That's my take on it.
Ten.
And Bennett Duda was to, you know, get some more points on the board. Here we go. Three match points for Liang Jingquan.
Unbelievable. Will he do it? He has.
He has, Liang Jingquan. It's been a ruthless performance today.